you won't believe how many of these actors didn't have any CGI use for their MCU character. Instead, they had hours in a makeup chair. Which actor had such intense body makeup and prosthetics that they literally had to sit in a sauna so it could melt off? How about the actor who carried an extra 8 pounds of weight on their head alone? CGI magic is impressive, but these extraordinary makeup, prosthetic, and costume transformations will blow you away. When it was time to be in the makeup chair, Michael B. Jordan spent a whole 2.5 hours every single day having a whopping 90 individual prosthetics glued and sealed on his body, leaving the actor totally exhausted by the end of it. What's worse is that he was nowhere near the end of his workday since he still actually had to shoot. As for the removal process, well, he was stuck in a sauna to help all the prosthetics actually sweat off.
There she is, in all her glory.
When Tom Hiddleston put on his Loki suit, he was carrying around an extra 30 pounds. Add the headpiece, an extra 8 pounds. A whopping 40 extra pounds at all times. This large and heavy helmet covers Hiddleston's ears, which also limit how much he was able to actually hear. The suit itself was extremely hot and sweaty for the actor, and with the helmet, well, he was facing an overwhelming icky sweat fest every single day. Hiddleston said the whole experience was uncomfortable and left him feeling really claustrophobic.
Where the first piece locks you like that, the second piece zips up and locks you like that, and the third piece is like, eh.
The new Captain America is here. But for Wyatt Russell, it's been a long time coming. He auditioned for the role years ago. When he was cast as the new Captain, he actually asked if he could wear Chris Evans's suit. What we see him in here in the Falcon and the Winter Soldier, though, is a new costume made just for him. A hot, stiff, difficult, and painful costume. It was so bad that an old shoulder injury of his actually flared up. Part of the reason it's so uncomfortable is because there's supposed to be a sort of presentational effect. Have you ever seen a superhero with bad posture? Next time you watch the show, remember that Russell is working through loads of pain.
Every day there's something that's easier and something that's harder.
She looks good. There's no denying that, but at what cost? Well, Tessa Thompson knows, since she was the one wearing an almost entirely plastic outfit. Definitely not comfortable or breathable. Despite feeling incredibly stiff, hot, and always sweating, Thompson managed to act her way through it. If that weren't tough enough, she also had her fair share of wire work. Discomfort on top of discomfort.
My makeup goes on much faster, but it's like glue. They're actually glue transfers, then they stick to me.
Dave Bautista spent the end of every shoot day as Drax in a sauna. Not a bad gig, right? Think again. He also had a whopping 5 hours in the makeup chair every single day, getting 18 pieces of prosthetic attached and makeup done by 5 different makeup artists. If that weren't bad enough, Bautista had to stand for the majority of it with his arms sticking out. How he still had the energy to perform is a total mystery to us. So how does the sauna fit into all of this? Well, when he first had the makeup on, rubbing it off was so tough on his body that it damaged his skin to the point that he described it looking like hamburger meat. So the best solution was to put him in a sauna so the makeup could just melt off.
Coming together of Gamora every morning, that was a little grueling.
5 hours in the makeup chair before even starting on set is insane. But for Zoe Saldana, it became part of her daily routine when she was playing Gamora. Not only did she have loads of makeup and some facial prosthetics put on, she spent plenty of time being covered in this intense, thick green paste. Not a fun time at all. Elizabeth Debicki had a shorter prep time than many of the other Marvel characters, but she still spent a solid hour and a half with 2 makeup artists at work. Her prep pretty much involved being painted and allowing it to dry until she was ready to get into what was lovingly called the Aisha taco, aka this giant metal gold dress. While it looks regal and elegant, the costume was made almost entirely of metal, making it super heavy for her to move and work in. Debicki described it as similar to having a child hanging off your back. Yeah, not a great feeling. Robert Downey Jr. has had many costumes over the years when he played Iron Man. But one thing for sure is that none of them were enjoyable to wear. The actor said that his experience with the costumes was so tough at times, it almost led to a personality breakdown. This suit, it's no surprise to learn it's extremely heavy, stuffy, and hot. Remember, he doesn't just have to wear it, but perform intensely in it.
I can't believe I made a whole movie with this thing on.
Wyatt Russell may have wanted to wear Chris Evans' suit, but it's probably for the best that he didn't, since Evans detested wearing his Captain America suit. Overall, it was super tight and sweaty. We can see how fitted it is here. super tough considering how much he has to move and so athletically. The cap was confirmed to be the worst part of the costume. Not only is it kind of awkward looking, it was also super tight and uncomfortable and made it really tricky to hear others' lines. Can you imagine needing six people to help you get out of your clothes so you could go to the washroom? If not, ask Brie Larson, since this was her reality filming Captain Marvel in the skin-tight superhero getup. Getting into this costume itself? Well, that just took two people and a full half hour. And then there was the tight and restrictive helmet composed of five different pieces that all sort of slotted together on her head. Not only was she stuck wearing the extremely uncomfortable costume for hours on end, she also had to fly in it. Painful much?
The worst part is getting an itch because it's so thick.
Have you ever been on a 15-hour flight? If so, you know it is super uncomfortable, and according to Ant-Man himself, Paul Rudd, that is exactly what wearing his costume was like. The suit is skin tight, thick, and extremely hot, especially when shooting in Atlanta, Georgia. Rudd admitted that one of the worst parts of wearing the suit was when he had an itch that needed scratching. The suit made it impossible, so he resorted to literally having people on set punch the itchy spots in hopes of deterring the discomfort. It looks like he could still enjoy himself through the pain, though. Karen Gillan essentially has Nebula's skin glued right onto her. See how they added all the prosthetics? While it looks smooth enough, the process was actually quite intense and claustrophobic for the actress. The whole transformation usually took an insane 5 hours to complete, often giving Gillan a start time of 2 a.m. These eyes? Courtesy of 22mm wide black contact lenses. Definitely adds to the claustrophobic feeling. By the way, there is no CGI used on her in the final cut of the film.
When I had the audition, I had no idea how big the character would be.
Palm Clementieff had to spend a crazy 3 hours in the makeup chair each day she was shooting to transform into Mantis. On top of that, Clementieff said keeping a straight face in the makeup chair was super challenging as well.
Thank you very much.
So how exactly did they accomplish this exotic look? Small prosthetics at the top of her forehead acted as marks for her antennae, and her bug-like eyes were courtesy of huge black contacts. It looks cool, but she was left feeling super claustrophobic and uncomfortable because of them.
We do this great black war paint. It's like a tar painted across my face.
Ronan the Accuser looks incredible on screen, but how much work went into bringing him to life? Well, Lee Pace spent countless hours sitting in the makeup chair being painted a periwinkle color, having veins painted in, and of course, these thick black bits on his face. Pace described it like having tar on your face, which doesn't make the whole acting thing easy. It was so painful and restrictive, his face couldn't move naturally at all while it felt so stiff and heavy. On top of all that, he had purple contacts and a headdress. Torture much?
Even just to do this is like 2 pounds, 6 pounds, 10 pounds, 50.
When Michael Chiklis took on the role of the Thing in the first two Fantastic Four films, CGI wasn't quite as advanced as it is now. So he wore a full suit made out of latex and rubber. It took 2 hours to get the full costume on, prosthetic teeth included. When it came to performing, Chiklis struggled with such a stiff costume that made simple tasks like sitting or picking up a bottle of water extremely tough because whenever he moved, the suit would actually tighten and tense up, leaving him in loads of pain.
It was the hottest I've ever been.
Typically, we hear about actors having to get in shape for their Marvel roles, but it was a totally different story for Chris Hemsworth. While he didn't gain weight for his time as Fat Thor, he did carry around some extra weight. An insane 60 to 70 pounds, to be exact. Oh yeah, that's just how much the prosthetics weigh without armor. The suit limited how much he was able to move and was generally extremely uncomfortable and super hot. We had no idea so many of these actors struggled so much while wearing their costumes and still managed to give stellar performances. Not to mention the amazing makeup artists who spent so many hours on their feet bringing these characters to life. While it's intense, we definitely wouldn't mind a sauna at the end of shooting every day. Maybe hold all the prosthetics though.